Okay, today we're going to talk about Lempel-Ziv-Welsh. Let's do an example. We assume that you already know the theory. We want to transmit something like A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B. And first of all, we have to build a dictionary, will be the ASCII code. So it will start from zero and have some code. Up to 65, that is our uppercase A, 66, that is our uppercase B, up to 255, that is something. Then we will choose to have an enlarged dictionary, that we have 256, that is our end marker. And whatever comes after this will have to be built dynamically. So we don't know what it is, and so on. So we can assume that both the sender and the receiver already know all of this, because the first part here is simply ASCII, and we just add the one symbol in the mapping, and so we can assume that this is our shared base. What we are going to do is for every step, we will take a symbol that is the longest one that we find in our dictionary, and always add one element inside the dictionary. So let's start. The first symbol is an A, and we don't have AB or something like AB and something else inside the dictionary, because the dynamic part of the dictionary is still empty. And so we just emit the code for A, that is 65. And then we are going to add something that will be starting with A. It would be good the next time that we find A followed by a B, this is our look ahead character, that we actually have this combination inside the dictionary. So we will put this inside the dictionary, and we can advance on to the next character that we still have to transmit. And so it is something that starts with B, but the only string that we have that starts with B here is this one. So we are going to emit 66. And again, we pick one character ahead, that is an A, and we basically say it will be good the next time that we find B and A to have a code for this. And so we will just put B and A. Now we have our pointer here, and we look for something that starts for A, but we have two strings that start for A. One is this and one is this. So we actually find that there is an AB here. So this is our best match. And we will emit this. And then we say, now that we have emitted this, it will be good next time, again, one character look ahead, to have this combination here. The one that we just emitted plus one character, that is our look ahead character. So we will put this inside our dictionary. That will be A, B, A. So how is it built? It is built from the whole sequence that we emitted, that is this one, plus the next character that we have in our look ahead, that is this A here. Okay, let's go on. At this point, we find that our pointer is here, and we actually find ABA. That is what we just put inside, and it is the longest string that we have, so it is a perfect match. We are sending one character, and with one character, we are sending actually three letters. So it is starting to work very well. So it's 259 here, and again in position 260, we have to put whatever we put here, that is this sequence here, A, B, A, plus the look ahead character, that is this B here. And so we have another item inside our dictionary. Now we still have to emit this, so we look for something that starts with B. We have this and this, and so this is the best match. We will emit 258 and build up another entry in our dictionary that will start with what we just emitted, BA, plus the look ahead character, that is this B here. Okay. Now we are here, and we see that actually we have BAB, we just put it inside the dictionary, and we will emit 261. 1. Now we don't add a 262 because we reached the end of the string, so we don't have anything to add. And at this point, we will have to send the end to 256. And this is how the encoding works. So now let's assume that we are on the receiving side and we just received this sequence here. And of course, we are starting from a clean slate, so we don't know this mapping here. And we will just move it somewhere else. And we are starting from an empty dictionary. So what do we do? Well, we will try to apply the same algorithm and see what comes out. Of course, we are not going to be able to do a look ahead, but so this will mean that we will always be one step behind, but it will not be a problem, as we will see. So first code is 65 that we have in our dictionary, and it corresponds to the A, and we will put an A. Then we have 66, and the thing is that if we are going to follow the same algorithm, we are going at every step to build one item inside our dictionary. So we will start building the item inside the dictionary with what we just emitted, A, plus we will have to add the first character of the next sequence, because when we did the dictionary construction at the beginning, we were always emitting a sequence plus the next character in the sequence. In the input sequence. So we start building 257 with an A and some unknown character, and this unknown character will be what comes out of 66, that is B. So we emit B and we know what to put here, but we also know that we are going to start filling up the next item inside the dictionary with this B, that is the whole sequence that we put out here, plus the first character or whatever will come next. So we put a dot to remember that we have two other characters. And the next one that we have to emit is 257 that we have in our dictionary, and is AB. So again, we take the first character and we put it here, and we take the whole sequence and start building up the next item inside the dictionary. That will be AB and some unknown at the moment. And what happens now is that we have actually to emit 259. Now we don't know all of 259, we know the first two characters, but it is what we need actually, because if we start emitting the first two characters, A and B, and something that will have to be put, we got to know what is the first character of the next sequence, that is this A here, and so we know what to put here, that is an A, and so we know what to put here, that is again an A. So basically, when we find out this kind of situation in which we don't know the full sequence corresponding to some item, it's actually something that we are going to produce very easily from what we already have. That is, we have to take the previous sequence, in this case AB, and append the first character to it, and in this case have ABA. So okay, we can go on. We start building the next item in the sequence, that is ABA with the first character of the following one. So we get the following one is 258. We have it is BA. We take the first character, fill in the blank here, and we are ready to start the following item with this sequence here, that is BA. Again, BA and some unknown. Now we have to emit 261, which is what we are after here, but we know the trick at the moment because we can start filling in this 261 with BA something. Now we know the first character that we can put here, and so we know what to put here too. And after this we have 256, that is just the end of our string. So what did we find out? It is A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 groups. Like here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 groups. And if we compare what we had in the encoder with what we have built dynamically in the decoder, we see that the dictionary that we built up is exactly the same.